So you know email marketing is kind of a big deal, but you have no idea where to get started. This whole technology thing is a little bit confusing and it's making you so overwhelmed. Well, in this video, I share 9 steps to creating an email marketing campaign using Mailchimp's free platform. Hello, I'm Kate Emiley and welcome to my channel. I'm a brand and content strategist and love helping small businesses like yours build their brands online. So if you're new here, please consider subscribing because I release new videos every Tuesday where I share tutorials, hacks, and case studies, as well as interviews and business mindset strategies to help you to keep killing it in your biz. But in this video, I'm going to be sharing the 9 steps to getting started with email marketing for free. So email marketing has had a bit of a bad rep lately because a lot of businesses are just using it as a way to push out their message to their entire email list. So this is really noisy content that offers little value to their audience. But with an email list, if you can leverage it properly, the really cool thing is that you own your subscribers. So you control when your message goes out to your audience and who it goes out to. Unlike social media platforms like Instagram and Facebook, which have algorithms, email is always delivered to your audience. So if you're wanting to get started with email marketing and in the cheapest way possible, then this video is for you. I talk about how to use Mailchimp specifically because I use Mailchimp in my business and a lot of e-commerce brands are using Mailchimp, especially when they're just starting out because it allows you to use their service for free for up to 2,000 subscribers. So once you hit that 2,000 mark, you're likely to be in a position in your business where you're able to pay a monthly fee. But in those initial stages, having a free option that works wonders, it's a great platform, is such a great resource to have. So this is a total beginner's guide. So it's sharing the 9 steps to getting started with email marketing. So step 1 is to understand your goals. So getting really clear on what the purpose of your email campaign is all about or your email list. So if it's a newsletter to send out information about things that your business has been up to, make sure you get really clear on what is the value that you're going to be providing your audience and not just thinking about how you want to use it as a platform to just spruik your message. So for example, my email list beyond this, which I'd love you to subscribe to now if you haven't already, is all about sharing my entrepreneurial journey. So I get really personal on the types of content that I share. So I share my strategies, my challenges, new things that are working for me, things that aren't, changes in my business, to really be able to help small business owners understand, you know, how things are working and maybe I'm a few steps ahead of them so they can start seeing how they can change, make these changes in their own businesses moving forward. So getting really clear on what that purpose is just the first step to your email marketing campaign. Step 2 is to build your email list. So do you have a presence on social media? Start sharing that message on there through your stories and through your posts or even through your Instagram bio, which is a really sneaky way to do it. Or if you have a physical presence, so you've got a bricks and mortar store, just start asking people if they'd like to sign up to your newsletter, but get really clear on what the value is they're going to get from it, because just saying, sign up to my newsletter is not going to get the response you're looking for. Making sure that you have some clear call to action, some value, whether it be in the type of content that you share with them that's really exclusive, you're not sharing this with anyone else, or whether it's actually offering them something like a discount or free shipping or a free product on their next purchase for signing up. Step 3 is to set up a welcome email. So to set up this email straight after someone has subscribed using an automation service. Mailchimp has an automation service built in and it's really super straightforward of how you go through the process to creating a welcome email. But make sure that your welcome email covers the following things. So it needs to say thank you to people for subscribing. You need to give them whatever you've promised them, whether it's a discount or a freebie, and then actually share what it is that you're going to be offering them through your email. So get really clear on what that value is with them so they understand what they're going to be getting from you. And number four is to make sure that you share anywhere else you'd like them to follow you. So if you're on Instagram, make sure you have a call to action to say, follow us on Instagram, because then they start starting to build this bigger relationship with your brand as a whole. Step four is select the type of campaign that you're going to be sending. So if it is an email newsletter, just get really clear on what is the value that you're providing them, whether it's a tip or something that's really interesting to them, that's going to make them open it and also click through to your website. So make sure it's something really great value that you're not offering everywhere, and get really clear on how you're actually going to be giving them something that they're going to want to be reading. Or maybe you're wanting to send a promotion email. So this might be about a new product or a discount or a sale or something like that. Again, get really clear on what their pain points are. So understand what your consumers' concerns are right now and explain how your product or service can actually help them with that. Use eye-catching colors and buttons and all that sort of stuff to get really clear on getting that call to action to your site, but don't overcomplicate it. Don't offer too many call to actions in there, because then they're confused about what they should be clicking on next. Step five is to choose your email template. So Mailchimp offers a whole lot of different options for design, so a lot of templates, which is great. And while you may want to create a whole lot of different emails, stick to one template at least to start with, because you don't want to overcomplicate things. So just have one email template, and then make sure it's really resonating your brand, use your brand colors, your logo, your fonts if possible. Mailchimp doesn't have all fonts, but something that's close enough to your brand. And also, these templates are all mobile responsive. So what that means is if you're looking at it on a desktop, it will be responsive to, you know, a large screen. But if you're looking at it on mobile, it will be shrinked down. So it's not just automatically shrinked. They will move the images so it actually reads a lot better. But just be aware, you want to test this. Do a preview when you are ready to send, just to make sure your images look right and that sort of stuff. Sometimes your images can look a bit too big, so you may want to resize them at the start. Step six is to create the content. So people love to read content that is broken up into nice digestible chunks, because people don't just read an email word for word. They often skim through it and will look for headers of things that they think, yes, that's interesting, I want to find out more, and either read the email or click through to your link. So getting clear on how you can actually format your email in a way that's really engaging for your reader is really important, as is the content. So making sure that not every email that you send them is a promotion. Make sure it's split up with value providing content, whether it's tips, strategies, behind the scenes, whatever it is, to grow this bigger message about your brand, and then hit them with a promotion. I would say a promotion one every four emails. If you're an e-commerce provider, maybe one every eight if you're a service provider. But just making sure that it's not promotion, promotion, promotion. But don't put too many call to actions, because it's going to confuse your reader. I would suggest asking yourself, if I want them to click on one thing, what would that be? And just hone in on that call to action. Step seven is make sure you send a test. So you're able to send a test email to your personal email, and just make sure that all the links are working. Literally click through all of them, because you never know, you may have had a typo or have kept a link from a previous email. And so check all those out. Also double, triple check your spelling, especially in the subject line. If you have a spelling mistake in the subject line, it doesn't look super professional. I've seen brands do this before and it doesn't look real great. So make sure you triple check that and make sure the body copy makes sense, has a good flow, check what it looks like on your desktop as well as your mobile as well. Step eight is choosing when to send it. So while I don't think there is a blanket answer for everyone based on what is the best time to send out an email, I think it really depends on your audience and is something that you can test. So whether you're ready to send out your campaign straight after you finished it, that's fine. I often schedule it for the same time every week, just so I can start getting my readers into the behavior of knowing when my email comes out and roughly what time it comes out. It may not be to the T, just based on, you know, other work commitments and things like that. But I always send it out on a Tuesday afternoon so I can pre-promote this video, because I send these out, these go live on Tuesday, as well as talk about what I want to talk about in that email as well. And step 9 is to measure your results. So this is something you won't be able to do straight away. You'll have to wait till you've got a few campaigns under your belt. But I'd suggest every month, have a look at your email campaigns and see how they're performing. Are they getting better? Are they getting worse? Was there a particular topic that did really well? Particular topic that didn't do so well? On the reports in Mailchimp, you can see your open rate, your click-through rate, and your unsubscribe rate. So your open rate is dependent on your subject line. So how catchy and interesting is it? Is it provoking that sort of curiosity in your reader? As well as the content that you're actually known for. Because if you start to build a behavior that people know that the content you provide is amazing, they're gonna click open every single time. Your click-through rate is dependent on whether you have a really clear call to action in the email, as well as making sure that it's clear on what they should be doing next. What is the action that you're wanting them to take? And then your unsubscribes. Don't get disheartened by unsubscribes. It just means someone's not interested in getting your emails anymore, which is actually a good thing, because you want to have only people in your list that are actually really super engaged, because it affects the health of your list and lots of other things. So unsubscribes are fine. Just you want to make sure that you're not getting an increased number in unsubscribes. You only want to get a couple. So that's my 9 steps to using email marketing for free. So now you have no excuses not to send any emails out to your audience and to focus on email marketing as a strategy. So if you'd like to see how I do this, sign up to my email Beyond This, which is all about the ideas, strategies, challenges, and things that are coming up for me as a business owner in this entrepreneurial space. I'm in the trenches like you, so maybe there's something that you can learn from me. I'm getting a lot of feedback from this email because it is so honest and raw, and I'm sharing stuff that I'm learning along the way. So if you'd like to subscribe, there's a link in the description below. I'd love to have you as a subscriber, and please give me any feedback on it and things that are resonating with you. Next up, go and watch my video about how to create a content calendar on Trello for free. It's been a really popular video, so I'm sure it's going to be something that you're going to get a lot of value out of. But that's it for me for today. So if you loved this video, please give it a thumbs up. And if you're new here, consider subscribing, because I release new videos on marketing and mindset strategies for small businesses that are wanting to grow their brands online. But I will see you next Tuesday with another video I know you're gonna love. I got a few email marketing ones up my sleeve, so if this is a topic that interests you, subscribe, because you're gonna be able to see some really great content coming out in the next few weeks. But that's it for me, so until next time, bye for now.